I started here nearly 6 years ago, and I was pretty close to 98 kilos, and now I'm running at 78 to 80 kilos.
We didn't want to have a legacy that when people started working at NCIG over the years and years, you know, slowly gain a few kilos, a few kilos, a few kilos. And yeah, I guess we just wanted to have that ultimate goal of improving their overall health and wellbeing.
For me, it was more about, you know, the services as far as health assessments and education. I thought I was looking okay. I was sitting on probably 97, 98 kilos. I thought I was hiding it pretty well, but got a pretty frank assessment that I was on a bit of a downward spiral. Went from there and got a bit of education as far as how much I should be eating and, you know, calorie intake and calories in versus calories out and all that sort of thing. And end up losing 10 kilos or so.
So day one, we were team challenge. I was in one of the maintenance teams and got the Garmin, learned how to sync it to my phone. And the very first day I did 10,000 steps. Pretty well after that first week, I said to my wife, you know, I'm going to win this challenge. I live over at Stockton, so I walked to work, walked over the bridge, walked back home. After I'd get home, I'd walk around Stockton another time. I'd do 30,000 one day, 38,000 another day. I'd walk in the rain, walk in the cold. In the end, I end up doing 1.9 million steps in 8 weeks. And the last week in particular, I did 100,000 steps just to build a big buffer zone between me and second spot. So probably went a bit over the top.
Yeah, never expected anything like Brett's Brett's participation level. He really blew everyone else out of the water, but it was really good because he then, I guess that continued to motivate everybody else. You know, we always set ourselves a pretty high target of around 70% participation in any of our challenges. Our most recent challenge, in our Bounce Fit challenge, we had 98% participation.
So physically, at the time, I dropped 8 kilo.
What we've done is we've had a board made that simulates ship loading. So the muscles you would be using are upper body muscles. We've got another one that simulates sampling. So in other words, more bending and stretching.
A lot of jobs we get into, it's awkward positioning. Fine if you keep stretching throughout the day, makes us feel better towards the end of the day.
Getting in those awkward positions, trying to get low, doesn't help. You don't get much cramps or anything anymore.
We've had no strains since we've been doing it all, so that's a plus.
Me personally, I've been in this industry now for 37 years, and I can honestly tell you that this company, by far, blows other companies out of the water as far as commitment to people's health. Anytime you need help, NCIG's there.